我确认一下，目前大家是否可以看到 PPT，听到我的声音，给我一个反馈，谢谢。今天好奇怪呀，没问题啊，稍等稍等，我在这边拍一张照片啊，因为我这边的直播端显示的是未直播，这是一个非常奇怪的情况，给我大约20秒的时间，谢谢，耽误大家20秒。所以请我的场控的 Emma 和 Air 帮我确认一下，目前我的直播是正常的，但是很奇怪，我这边这个显示的状态是未直播的状态。好的，请技术同事帮我确认一下，目前我直播间是正常的，但是这边的这个指标显示的是未直播。这样吧，同学们，为了保证这节课程稍后能够正常的生成录播，我重新退出再进一下，我重新退出再进一下，大家稍微等我10秒钟的时间，抱歉，好。好，感谢各位同学，我们的课程正式开始。这里是来自于建坤老师的专业八级听力课程，今天是我们的强化过程当中的最后一节课程。我们先确认一下，再度和各位同学见面的时间是什么时间？再度和大家见面的时间是这个时间点，请大家注意，我们在3月1号开始将进入冲刺版本的课程。现在请各位同学拍照，将这样一张页面当中的说明进行记录。我们来说一下，在最后未来的时间当中，大家需要做一些什么事。首先确认一件事情，2月1号之前，请大家确认的是重点和弱点的课程录播版，再听1到2遍。其中听力课程最为重要的是听力的第一节课程到第四节课程。相同道理，范范老师的阅读课程完全可以再重新回顾一下他的写作和阅读的环节。当然，你认为曲根老师词汇课非常的好，平时就当是一个录播或者是耳边的一个伴随的这样一个声音啊，不断去刷就可以了。接下来。2月28日之前，请各位同学务必要做到的是，手中的所有专业八级真题试卷全部完成。其中，1月份到3月1日之间，来自于10年之内的迷你演讲的稿件的多遍听力和潜在答案速记的训练，这件事情的方法论，请各位同学关注我们的第三节课程和第四节课程。我相信大家明白我在说些什么。那么，迷你演讲这些真题到底应该怎么去进行课后的拆解？这件事情非常的重要，已经说过，关注我们的讲解。接下来1月份到3月份之间，你就去做这件事情就可以了。接下来2月24号，注意一下时间，各位同学模拟考试。2月24号模拟考试，请各位同学在提前的时间下载试卷，并且进行打印。啊，提前下载试卷，并且进行打印。 或者是各位同学回去看一下，你们的真题书当中可能会有模考试卷，如果没有的话，请大家记得提前做好打印的准备。然后从3月1号开始，我们将进入到冲刺阶段的课程当中。这本书当中的冲刺阶段的内容，各位同学提前不用去关注它。如果提前做了的话，意义不大。其实冲刺阶段当中最重要的是通过一些题目的一些配合和这样的一个组合，让大家尽快的回顾一下之前学过的技巧。所以讲义当中的冲刺环节不要去关注，大家只需要在3月1号之前完成这张 PPT 上给大家安排的规定动作就可以了。很明显，重点应该是在这里，完成真题以及完成10年迷你演讲的潜在答案和速记训练。另外，我相信很多同学已经去我们的页面上进行了6级听力真题的音频和题目的下载，已经成功获得真题的这个文件，包括音频文件的同学给我一个反馈，举手。已经在我们的有道精品课页面成功下载到6级真题和音频的同学举手。有同学说没有微博，没关系啊，今天晚上我们在微信当中会把这样一个地址重新再给大家发一遍。但是下载过程当中，很明显，电脑版将更加的方便。电脑版将更加的方便。另外，11年之间的迷你演讲的音频题目和原文，到目前为止依然有同学没有搞定。这张照片拍下来，然后存在你的手机当中，你可以随时的传递给需要去解救的英语专业八级党。好，就是这样。That's it。那么我们把后面的事情已经安排好了。再度提醒大家，你们已经做了非常多的工作。1月份到3月份之间这2个月的时间当中，最重要的一件事情就是保存你们的实力。其实我真希望在12月底就参加考试，这样的话，其实你们甚至会考出一个更好的成绩。2月份可能会出现一些特别多的麻烦，比如说春节、情人节各种各样的节日，可能会使各位同学的心绪比较浮躁，所以一定要按照我的要求，10年真题完全搞定。接下来的时间，进入到今天的课程当中来，做好准备。迷你演讲结束，长对话。昨天在前天的课程当中已经见过了2套，接下来的时间技巧正式出现，动手，笔记本。辛苦了。对了，然后还有同学会在本周末考研，有没有同学参加本周末的考研？如果有的话，举一下手，祝你考研成功。加油啊！还有可能正在关注录播课程的工作党，下班之后累成狗，还要去听课，哇，真有啊，辛苦大家了。其实建议大家在最后一周肯定是以我们的考研为主，大家完全可以在考研结束之后，心情平复之后来看我们的录播。好了，不再多说话，做好准备，现在关注一下什么叫做顺序出题和词语定位呢？对于迷你演讲之后的长对话来说，提醒大家，我们的长对话和4、6级的出题方式非常的相像。第一件事情是，一定是顺序出题。不会跳题，一定是一步一步来。男士一回合，女士一回合，男士一句，女士一句，一个回合结束之后，一道题可能就结束答案的配给了。另外，如何进行题目的切换呢？非常的简单。当我们发现有一些单词和短语在一个题目的选项当中出现，就意味着这个选项所在的题目范围正式开始，我们要进行题目的切换，或者是题目范围的缩小。所以这可以解决一个问题，这个问题就是部分同学所说的，现在我不知道应该做哪一道题目了。我们再说一遍，现在应该做哪一道题目，不是靠听的，而是靠看的。再说一遍，能理解吗？现在该做哪一道题目，不是靠我们的听力，而是靠我们在听的过程当中发现某些单词和短语被读到时，那个选项所在的题目范围就是目前正在进行的题目的范围。所以，当选项当中某个单词被读到时，这道题的范围正式开始。现在，我们先从一道定位题目的训练点正式进入到今天的课程当中来。全班同学翻书本，编号为26页。动手，在26页的时候，各位同学会看到这道题目，编号为26页，32题到第35题，准备好。给反馈是否已经准备好了？32题到35题，好的，我很快的带着各位同学看一下整个选项的排列情况。编号为32题，选项非常短。那么这样的选项可能会在暗示一件事，那就是多个选项会被读到。能懂我的意思？没问题，继续。编号为33题， 在33题当中，提醒大家，我们说过选项的核心看什么位置，这是上一节课的要点。选项的核心关注动宾结构或系表结构，还有印象，以及请关注选项过程当中的比较级、最高级、数据等等。所以33题 A 选项应该是一个表里的状态，叫做 done manually，用人工的方式来做。B 选项的核心应该是有一个比较级 more and more，以及一个动宾结构 lose jobs。C 选项的核心应该是 change the nature。D 选项的核心应该是 enjoyable, right, enjoyable 这样的一个表演的状态。相同道理，34题是一个动宾结构，而35题一样也是动宾结构。大家看一下35题，35题如果是 A 选项的话，请大家一定要注意，A 选项当中会有一个核心，这个单词叫做 not。对于否定词汇，一定要做一下标记。A 选项当中的 not 绝对是一个重点。A 选项的核心应该是 not bring benefits。再说一遍，35题 A 选项的核心应该是 not bring benefits。能懂我的意思了？这就是我们选项当中的核心点。但是一定要接受一个情况，那就是并没有太多的时间可以看，以及一定要养成边听边看的这样一种超强能力，并且不要给自己施加去翻译选项的能力。举个例子来讲，大家看一下35题 C 选项，在35题的 C 选项当中，they are arbitrarily set by the administrators，一定会有同学不认识 arbitrarily，同意吗？再来一遍，arbitrarily，arbitrarily 这个单词一定会有人不认识，能跟上？Hello，arbitrarily 35题 C 选项，懂我的意思？这样的情况在专业八级当中很常见，如果遇到的话，千万记住不要做一件事儿。有人喜欢通过打圈的方式让自己更加的紧张，说看这个单词你不认识。但是我不建议大家这样做。上场考试的时候，不认识这个单词就直接忽视它，不要去管它。首先，它并不是核心。C 选项的核心其实是应该是 set by the administrators。前方那个 arbitrarily 对你来说影响不大，是否懂都不要给造成负面的麻烦。你不会因为把它打了一个圈儿，就在现场考试时突然懂了，不要给自己增加额外的心理负担。这道题目做好准备，它是一篇短文听力，但是对于各位来说很有用，它能告诉大家如何在题目当中进行切换，并且请小心32题的形式，加油。
Passage 3. It is logical to suppose that things like good labor relations, good working conditions, good wages and benefits, and job security motivate workers. But one expert, Frederick Herzberg, argued that such conditions do not motivate workers. They are merely satisfiers. Motivators, in contrast, include things such as having a challenging and interesting job, recognition, and responsibility. However, even with the development of computers and robotics, there are always plenty of boring, repetitive, and mechanical jobs, and lots of unskilled people who have to do them. So how do managers motivate people in such jobs? One solution is to give them some responsibilities. Not as individuals, but as part of a team. For example, some supermarkets combine office staff, the people who fill the shelves, and the people who work at the checkout into a team and let them decide what product lines to stock, how to display them, and so on. Many people now talk about the importance of a company's shared values or culture, with which all the staff can identify. For example, being the best hotel chain, or making the best, the most user-friendly, or the most reliable products in a particular field. Such values are more likely to motivate workers than financial targets, which ultimately only concern a few people. Unfortunately, There is only a limited number of such goals to go round. And by definition, not all the competing companies in an industry can seriously claim to be the best.
Questions 32 to 35 are based on the passage you have just heard. Question 32. What can actually motivate workers according to Frederick Hertzberg?Question 33. What does the speaker say about jobs in the computer era? Question 34. What do some supermarkets do to motivate their employees?Question 35. Why does the speaker say financial targets are less likely to motivate workers?
Another question is, how can Toastmasters help you in job situations?
大家各位同学，我们宣布一下准确答案的形式。我觉得这篇文章还挺有意思的，大家看一下准确答案的形式啊，大家看一下准确答案的形式，给反馈，成功了吗？来告诉我你们的成功率是多少？成功率是多少？恭喜大家错一个，如果要错的话，今天基本上比较难的题目应该是编号为33题，恭喜全队的同学 ，congratulations。来，这道题应该是在33题上错误比较多吧？有没有感觉33题几乎没有任何机会，这道题就结束了？34题错误的同学，好，我现在说一下这道题的来源，大家一定要保持冷静。这道题目的时间是2008年大学英语四级听力的短文听力环节的一道题目。再说一遍，这是2008年大学英语四级听力的一篇短文听力。是的 ，College English Test Band 4。这的确是一道四级听力的题目。大家现在心情是一个什么样的状态？多年的幻想，多年的这种幻境被瞬间打破了。哎呀，真是。所以大家寒假听力比较弱的，真的跟着我去六级听力吃透班，或者是四级听力吃透班，赶紧把你们的听力元气给补一补吧。不多说了，做好准备，这道题我放第二遍，在第二遍的过程当中讲这道题为什么那个准确答案是这样排列的，以及你们应该如何进行题目的切换。想哭就放声大哭吧，但核心问题是这道题怎么回事，加油。好，这是一道四级听力的题目。
Passage 3.
准备。首先介绍一下背景。这个人的名字叫做 Frederick Hertzberg。我没有给大家安排原文，大家可以通过百度直接可以通过选项找到原文的形式。他讲的是美国劳动力学家赫兹伯格先生的一个理论。学过管理学的同学肯定听说过这个理论，叫做 Dual Theory， 叫做双因素理论。也就是说，人在工作单位当中有两种东西会激励他，第一种叫保健因素 satisfier， 第二种叫做激励因素叫 motivator。 那么这个人认为 satisfier 保健因素对于人的这种激励作用是有限的，只有 motivator 也就是激励因素对于一个人在工作当中的状态才有真正的激励影响。开始。
It is logical to suppose that things like good labor relations
32题 B 选项被点到，非常标准的一个点勾，继续。
Good working conditions, good wages and benefits.
来自于 D 选项 wages and benefits。当 B 选项和 D 选项同时被读到时，我们就知道 B 和 D 是不能够入选的。给反馈，懂我的意思吗？这应该是并列选项的出现。
And job security。
A 选项叫 security。小心，这个点我们在马斯洛人类需求理论那一点当中考过，大家有印象吗？叫 security pension plan 有印象。我们把它理解为叫做这个工作的保险。继续。
Motivate workers。
说这些东西是可以去激励员工的。
But one expert, Frederick Herzberg, argued that such conditions do not motivate workers.
他认为这些东西是不会激励员工的。
They are merely satisfiers.
他们都被称之叫保健因素 ,satisfier. 继续。
Motivators, in contrast, include things such as having a challenging and interesting job.
Having challenging or interesting job. 替换形式出现来自于我们的 C 选项。Challenging or interesting job. 大家看一下，这也是专业八级题目的一个设计规范。准确答案经常是统一替换加视听一致的组合。准确答案经常是统一替换加视听一致的组合。编号为32题，来自于我们的这个 C 选项。同时我们也介绍一下，在专业八级的设计当中基本上也会出现这样的情况。大家记不记得关于大卫杜楚尼的那篇文章？那么我们会发现的是，干扰选项会轮番出现，是并列出现，然后过一会儿准确答案可能会隔一些时间出现。从位置上来讲的话，这种题目它喜欢在靠后的位置设置一个比较独特的选项形式。好，这道题结束了，继续往下。
Recognition and responsibility。
现在问题就来了，33题什么时候开始？这就是33题最难的地方。首先，32题每一个选项都已经过了一遍，这道题必须结束。你的眼神目前已经框在33题上，33题的选项相对较长，问题就来了，大家一定记住我们做题方针，你的眼神是在33题的 A 到 D、 D 到 A 当中不停的看。给反馈，懂我的意思了？你的眼神一定要在33题的 A 到 D、 D 到 A 当中不停的看，以保证人家读到准确答案时你的速度够快。这个建议是给比较普通的同学。那么实力已经接近专八或能过专八的同学可以不考虑我。什么叫实力比较普通？就是这篇题目错误率达到两个或以上的同学，请你小心。
However, even with the development of computers and robotics,
computers 已经出现，而且前方出现了一个大转折。However, 这个语句我在 PPT 上已经呈现出来了，看不懂的同学现在可以看一下 PPT, 原文是这样写的。
There are always plenty of boring, repetitive, and mechanical jobs, and lots of unskilled people who have to do them.
结束，我们来认识一下33题最可怕的事情发生了。B 选项、A 选项、C 选项和 D 选项均有个别单词被读到。大家看，分别是 A 选项 jobs, B 选项 unskilled jobs, C 选项 computer jobs, D 选项表面上看起来更加的完整。看到了一个 boring jobs, 看出来了吗？如果这道题大家的能力一般，属于同义替换完全没有能力的同学，也就是非听力能力者，只会视听一致，听什么选什么。33题我建议你选择 D 选项。希望大家可以理解我，也就是听力的水平处于入门或中级以下的同学，33题你是 hold 不住的，这道题是纯同义替换。这道题如果你来做，以后遇到这样的题目依然使用对你来说保险更大的方法，就是选择 D 选项，因为看起来 D 选项的成功概率略高一点，两个被读到的单词连在了一起。但是你必须要明白的是，更高级别的做法 D 选项也不能碰，因为 D 选项的核心根本不是 boring jobs 这样一个主语，而是它最终出现的一个状态叫 enjoyable。 所以33题对于很多人来说没手碰了，没法碰，为啥？这道题全面统一替换。原文是这样说的，叫做：然而，随着计算机和机器人技术的发展，依然会有三种工作。看清楚，同学们 ，boring， 重复的 ；repetitive，mechanical， 叫做机械的工作，以及大量没有技术的人需要去做它们。言下之意是什么？无论技术怎么发展，大量重复的工作或辛苦的工作依然需要人来完成。大家看 A 选项的统一替换 ，tedious。这个单词的形式替换了三个，瞬间替换，乾坤大挪移，臣妾做不到啊。 Boring Repetitive, mechanical, 替换的是 tedious, 给反馈，懂了吗？而人来做这样一件事，替换的形式叫 manually。这是四级的绝对的高级别的统一替换，即便专业八级的同学在做也会有麻烦。这道题结束了，继续往下。33题结束之后，下一题何时开始准备？
So how do managers motivate people in such jobs? One solution is to give them some responsibilities.
像这样的句子，专业八级的同学一定有感觉了。这样的句子我们在上一节课已经听过了很多。在上一节课听长对话的时候，大家是否听说过这样的说法，叫做 The problem is, the challenge is, 这种非常明显的表示强调或者是一个结论的话，相同道理，这句话也来了。
However, even with the development of computers and robotics, there are always plenty of boring, repetitive and mechanical jobs.And lots of unskilled people who have to do them.
我们再说一遍，在这里。
So how do managers motivate people in such jobs? One solution is to give them some responsibilities. One solution is to give them some responsibilities. One solution is to give them some responsibilities. One solution is to give them some responsibilities.
大家看一下，当你听到 give them some responsibilities 的时候。这地方的 one solution 实际上是一个非常明显的一个信号。一般来说 give them some responsibilities 这句话至少要重复，这句话的一个语速至少是一到两秒钟左右的时间。你的眼神如果转得够快的话， A 到 D， D 到 A 当中，完全有机会让你转到 D 选项上， D 选项机会继续给你机会。
Not as individuals but as part of a team，
这道题就比较简单了。
For example，Some supermarkets.
现在我的问题是做好准备，请大家感受一下，当34题选择结束之后，我们一定要记住啊，在我们的这个专业八级听力当中也是，选完之后最好能够等两到三句话，以确定其他选项对于我们的威胁不够大，同时还需要眼神再往下拉一拉，看一看下方的题目的点是否被读到。下方题目的点一旦被读到，我的眼神直接甩掉34题进入35题。但如果下一道题的点还没有被读到，我的眼神必须要在上一道题当中再停留两到三句话。我解释清楚了吗？再说一遍，一道题的准确答案选完之后，最好能够在本题当中等两到三句话，但你的眼神必须要在35题当中也开始看。如果在这两到三句话之间，35题选项当中的单词已经被读到，马上舍掉上方的题目，开始看下一道题，就这个意思，加油。
Combine office staff, the people who fill the shelves.
那这道题来说已经出现，因为你听到了一个单词的形式 staff.
For example, some supermarkets combine office staff, the people who fill the shelves, and the people who work at the checkout into a team.And let them decide what product lines to stock, how to display them, and so on. Many people now talk about the importance of a company's shared values or culture, with which all the staff can identify. For example, being the best hotel chain, or making the best, the most user-friendly, or the most reliable products in a particular field.
好的，我来说一下，在这个过程当中，普遍很多同学的感受应该是有听懂的位置，但是大量内容应该是抓不住的。有一些点能够抓住，比如说 best, hotel, 能够抓住这样一些点，但是发现35题的 A 到 D, D 到 A 当中是没有的，心中出现了一种惯常的慌乱感。听力过程当中经常会出现这种感觉，大家有这种感觉吗？就是我实在是不知道35题什么时间开始。有利比，就总觉得出现了一种可能性，那就是我想选一个，因为我担心准确答案已经被我 miss 掉了。但是我选完之后发现，这个选项也非常非常的不确定，内心更慌了。继续。
Such values are more likely to motivate workers than financial targets, which ultimately only concern a few people.
结束了，再来一遍准确答案形式。
Which ultimately only concern a few people than financial targets.Which ultimately only concern a few people.
这就是我们做题的机会，当然 准确答案形式结束之后，老规矩，再等两到三句话 ，confirm a few people。然后如果说你还有机会，回头看一看 ，a few 替换的应该是 a small number of。
Unfortunately, there is only a limited number of such goals to go round, and by definition, not all the competing companies in an industry can seriously claim to be the best.
结束了。这篇文章做完了，大家看一下整个文章啊、其实对于各位来说最重要的一件事情，今天我要去说的一定是题目之间切换的一个感觉和顺序，也就是你会发现一道题的节奏感非常重要。大家有那种感觉吗？就是整个每一道题我卡位卡得很准，这个卡位绝对不是靠听力理解来进行卡位的。我再说一遍，一定是当某一个题目的选项单词被读到时，无论你是否把上一道题做完，你的眼神都必须要卡住这道题的 ABCD 了。大家一定要仔细听建坤讲这句话，这对于我们做长对话的节奏非常重要，和整个听理解的关系并不大，核心是这个选项当中的单词或短语是否被读到，你的眼神就必须要跟到了。仅凭你的听力理解，大家目前 hold 不住听力当中的长对话，因为它太长了。一旦大家陷入到听力理解当中，你会发现你对于选项的控制会非常的弱。不用说大家了，连我都是一样。只要一旦我陷入到对于整个原文的理解过程当中，无论如何，我对于选项视觉把握会非常非常的弱。所以在你们的实力还不如我或没有到达我的这个水平之前，请尽量多用一些视听一致的技巧做对更多的题目。所以我再给大家多说一句话，包括稍后即将开始听录播的同学，建坤让大家下载六级听力试卷以及音频，真的是一件非常重要的事情。因为一月份到二月份之间，你不和我上课你干嘛？我要么建议你跟着我上六级听力吃透班，唤醒你的听力实力；要么我就建议你有空就把这张试卷打印出来，不停地做六级听力题目，就是不停地刷选择题，找视听一致和同一化感觉，以及做题顺序的感觉。做好准备。关于定位的问题结束之后，2016年的题目测试，全班动手，页码位置27页，谢谢。做好准备，27页，2016年两道专业八级题目，我们的测试即将开始。选项很短啊，比我们想象的要短，所以几乎没有什么选项当中的这种价值。仔细看一眼，大家有没有感觉第一题不是善茬？因为它的选项比较短，多个选项被读到可能性较大，请做一些标识，并且做好准备等待问题。
Good evening, everybody. Today, we are pleased to have invited Maggie Schwartz from Harvard University to tell us her feeling of studying together with her mom. Well, Maggie.
Thanks. I am very happy to meet you all.
Maggie, are you and your mom studying the same major at the university?
Not really. She is studying in law school, and I am studying journalism. So you see, she is a graduate student, while I am an undergraduate.Since we started at the same time and hers is a four-year night program, our school schedules are synced.
Which means?
We follow the same schedule of study. We take our exams during the same busy weeks and experience similar relief at the end of December and May. Last spring, we compared notes on our cover letters and interviews for our job applications. Last June, as we were both preparing for our summer internships,My mother and I traded fashion advice. Presently, we will probably graduate within days of each other.
Interesting. Then you must have a lot in common at study.
You bet. As students, we've shared study habits. Take notes by hand, general truths, you can't avoid having a few bad professors and encouraging platitudes like, it's okay.
(笑)没有任何问题的形式。因为对于各位来说，只有两个选项是唯二正确的，或者是每一道题只有一个选项和原文是一模一样的。我不用安排问题的形式了，所有的问题的问法只有一个，就是以下哪一项和原文是符合的，或者是以下哪一项是对的，请选择。第一题并没有按照我的预期一样多个选项被读到，所以不用安排问题。好，结束了。那我们确认一下准确答案的形式，都应该做出来了。第一题准确答案形式来自于 C 选项，第二题准确答案形式来自于 A 选项。嗯，还有同学选择 C 选项吗？来看一下，虽然说第一题问的是这篇对话或者是访谈的主题是什么，其实只是一个问法，这个问法就是以下哪项是对的，以及第二题也是一样，在所有的各种表面上看相同的情况当中，只有一个东西是真正相同的。第二轮做好准备，加油，开始。
Good evening, everybody. Today, we are pleased to have invited Maggie Schwartz from Harvard University to tell us her feeling of studying together with her mom.
结束了 ,feelings, studying, mom. 大家看一下 ,studying, mom, 又是一个动宾系列的结构，成功。接下来 ,feeling, 替换形式 ,view,请小心 ,B 选项 opinion 进行了干扰。接下来 ,C 选项进行这样一个标识之后，老规矩等两到三句话，看一下是否有其他选项会被读到。继续往下分享。
Well, Maggie.
Thanks. I am very happy to meet you all.
Maggie, are you and your mom studying the same major at the university?
Not really.
好的，各位有没有感觉接下来的时间第二题实际上已经出现了一个单词的形式。这个单词是谁呀、啊？再来一遍。
University?
Not really.
Are you and your mom studying the same major at the university? The same major at the university?
虽然说 D 选项当中的 major 已经被读到，但是我更 care 的是来自于第二题当中有各种各样的 same。同学们，懂我的意思，也就是说我们要切题了。Major 对我来说意义已经不大，因为在第二题当中我扫了一眼，发现有大量的 same。于是我要换题了，继续往下，第二题开始。
Not really. She is studying in law school and I am studying journalism. So you see, she is a graduate student.
她是一个研究生 graduate student.
While I am an undergraduate.
I am an undergraduate. 我是一个本科生。哎呀，我来说一下我个人的经历啊，插一个小废话。2011年我在爱丁堡大学读的研究生。那个班级我们学的专业是 language teaching， 叫做语言教学。班级当中30多位同学，其中有2位同学岁数是非常大的。这2位同学都来自于北欧，一个是丹麦，一个是芬兰，是2位大姐，我不能说大妈了，2位大姐，岁数一个是56岁，一个是58岁，是我们这个班级当中岁数最大的2位同学。他们当时的情况就是，他们的女儿或者是儿子正好已经开始上大学了。然后他们认为他们已经完成了对于孩子的这样一个抚养和教育的工作。It's time to pursue my dream. 是时候该放飞自我追求梦想了。然后他们开始读研究生。所以这种情况在这个地方出现一个对话，我认为是很常见的一件事。然后他们的心态非常的好。丝毫并不觉得好像在这个班级当中是异类的那种感觉。所以多好啊。我也希望各位同学未来的生活是这样，而不是最终成为去给下一代的下一代奉献最后夕阳青春的爷爷和奶奶们。
Since we started at the same time and hers is a 4-year night program, our school schedules are synced.
Which means?
We follow the same schedule of study. We take our exams during the same busy weeks.
好，说白了就是时间表完全相同。现在呢 ，A 选项成功了。
The same busy weeks. Our exams during the We take our exams during the same busy weeks. We take our exams during the same busy weeks.
来自于 A 选项绝对没有任何问题，老规矩 ，A 选项成功了。 我也说过，在目前的改革之后的长对话当中，更多情况之下问的应该是以下哪一项是对的。等两到三句，没有，我们就换题。
And experienced similar relief at the end of December and May. Last spring, we compared notes on our cover letters and interviews for our job application.
大家看一下，我们听到那个结构应该是一个动宾，这道题有一定的难度。We compared notes 指的是我们比较笔记。再说一遍 ，compare notes。B 选项这个动宾结构是不对的，它是有相同笔记。能听到？继续往下，新点。
Last June, as we were both preparing for our summer internships,
当我们都在准备 summer internship, 当我们都在准备夏天的这样一个实习的过程当中，小心啊，准备实习，准备和实习倒还相同，差不多，申请呗，但是没有说相同实习。当我们都在准备实习时，绝对没有说当我们都在准备相同的实习时。继续。
My mother and I traded fashion advice.Presently, we will probably grab.
老规矩 traded fashion advice. 什么叫做 traded fashion advice? 我们之间互相去交流关于这个时尚的一些理念，动宾结构都不对。来看一下原始文案。大家看一下，对于各位来说，他们错误的方向分别是：首先 ，B 选项叫做比较笔记 ，C 选项叫做夏天的时候申请实习，并非相同实习 ，D 选项。原文商东说的是两人进行这种理念上的交换，这个单词不知道大家有没有听过，这个单词用的是 traded 交换这种说法。过，继续往下，新点，加油。第二种，鉴于大家在稍后做模拟题过程当中，包括我们历史真题当中会大量遇到，我把这种题的解法也跟大家做一个解释，但是我已经说过，这种题目在历史当中是一个过去的形式，在新版的2018当中都没有出现过，这就是非常著名的专四专八的历史题目，叫做细节甄选题。对，他特别喜欢问的就是以下哪一项没有被读到，以及以下哪一项是不对的。你们在这个寒假做题时会大量遇上这样的题目，因为它是历史真题的形式，以及部分对于专业八级的这个内容不算特别了解的出题人会把他们的这种形式出现在模拟题当中，但是你相信建坤，这种题目在未来的真题当中出现可能性比较小，你需要了解。有人说这个需要建立在听懂的基础之上，怎么说呢，你会发现有时是这样，但有时也未必需要，只需要你能听到并且进行排除就可以了。它的特征是什么？它的特征就是选项是相同属性的单词或短语。这种题一般都会是一个细节，也就是说经常是以半句话或者是单个单词的形式出现。这是历史上的题目，而问法一般是否定式的问法。当然这种问法我们现在已经不能确定，因为它是后方出现，但一旦出现这样的一种结构，稍后在寒假做真题时不用特别的担心即可。27页我们来关注一下 2.09 这样一个标识。好，六级听力班的内容稍后我来广告，我们先做题。第二题到第四题准备好盯住页码开始。
Heard.
Another question is, how can Toastmasters help you in job situations?
By becoming involved in Toastmasters, you will learn different methods of communicating what you really want to say. And equally important,You will learn what your audience expects from you, so you can deliver that message to them in a logical fashion. Some people are comfortable around friends, but when they appear before a group they don't know, they get tense. Our organization helps our members to get calm and organize thoughts and deliver them in an effective way.
2. The following are job benefits by joining Toastmasters, except...
。Can you also learn other skills, such as parliamentary procedures or being master of ceremonies?
Yes. Different assignments within Toastmasters involve not only preparation of speeches and then presenting these before an audience, but also the opportunity of serving as Toastmaster of the meeting. This assignment helps members practice being an MC for a meeting, that is, a master of ceremonies. Other assignments include serving as an evaluator for another speaker, or serving as grammarian, who will monitor use of filler words or phrases, such as, and, or, you know. Both of these assignments will allow the member to increase or enhance their listening skills.
Four. Toastmasters aims to train people to be all the following except.
这位 Cherish 同学，你要小心了。今天我们是这样做题的。首先，我播放的是第二题，他所应对的这样一个材料。然后呢，播放的是第二题的问题。在播放完第二题的所有对应的内容之后 ，Cherish 同学已经做出了第二题，也就是没有播放材料题目的答案。这让我感到非常的惊讶，所以你是怎么做到的？你是在如何没有听原文的情况之下，对下一道题进行了一个尝试性的判断呢？然后他发现有问题，重新再做了一下，当然也做错了，你要注意一下，不能这样。准确答案形式确认一下。Question 4 not mentioned grammar teacher.Question 2. 这道题目我相信大家应该知道来自于 dog 的选项，所以要认真。再来一遍，准备。
33. You want to say.
Does this help you in job situation? Another question is.
大家有没有感觉这道题在切题的时候用了一个非常棒的迷你演讲的方式，请大家告诉我这个切换词会是谁。
8 financial targets.
准备。
Another question is.
告诉我这个单词是谁，这是我们当年在迷你演讲讲解时说过的分段词汇的形式。这个单词就是著名的 another。这个点一出现，很明显我们要换题了。当时的题目序号第二题，很明显它要进行题目的切换。2009年，当年谈了一件事，这个东西呢叫做 Toastmaster。个别同学可能了解，是一个兴趣组织。Toastmaster 在网络上是可以找到的，叫做拓马。它做什么事情？很简单，是一个演讲力的培训组织。准备继续。
How can Toastmasters help you in job situations?
By becoming involved in Toastmasters, you will learn different methods of communicating what you really want to say.
大家看一下，同义替换形式非常的快，叫做 different methods of communicating. 大家看 different methods of communicating. 在整个一月份到二月份，当各位同学做六级听力真题或专业八级的听力真题时，不要忘记做一件事，这件事情就是能总结多少同义替换就总结多少同义替换。范范老师对于同义替换这样一门课程是非常重视的，他也需要各位在阅读过程当中不断的总结同义替换，听力和阅读最终高的这种维度上就在考这个。继续。
And equally important, you will learn what your audience expects from you, so you can deliver that message to them in a logical fashion.
很明显 ,audience expectation, expect, 全部成功 ,deliver, message, a logical fashion, 很明显。有逻辑的就得有组织的有顺序的。很明显 ,ABC 已经被读完了，继续。
Some people are comfortable around friends, but when they appear before a group they don't know, they get tense. Our organization helps our members to get calm and organize thoughts and deliver them in an effective way.
很明显，来自于 D 选项是不对的。这个组织并不会教你如何和陌生人相处，它只是说你和陌生人可能会有一些紧张感。但是我们需要做的是前方的三件事情。或接下来 question four， 下一题。
But airports
or serve
准备。
Can you also learn other skills such as parliamentary procedures or being master of ceremonies?
Yes. Different assignments within Toastmasters involve not only preparation of speeches and then presenting these before an audience, but also the opportunity of serving as Toastmaster of the meeting.
好的，我们来回顾一下刚才发生的一件事，再来一遍。
Two.The following are just
parliamentary procedures.
那位说那个喜欢我的同学，你一定是一个假粉。我姓赵，我叫建坤老师。一般来说，了解我的人都不会叫我建老师。很明显，你对我的爱是不够的。你是一个假粉。嗯。
Or being master of ceremonies?
Yes. Different assignments within Toastmasters involve not only preparation of speeches and then presenting these before an audience, but also the opportunity of serving as Toastmaster of the meeting.
在整个这一个点当中啊，开玩笑我们过了，核心问题是听到了一个点，这个点是 public speaker 这个点其实已经被读到了。我们再听一遍这个位置的描述，准备。
This assignment helps members practice being an MC for a meeting.
大家看一下什么叫 MC? MC 叫做主持人 ,Master of Ceremony. MC 直接就可以在口语当中表示为这样一个活动主持或现场主持这样的说法。C 选项成功了，继续。
That is a Master of Ceremonies. Other assignments include serving as an evaluator for another speaker.Or serving as grammarian.
大家看一下 evaluator 中文含义指的是评估者。这是一个专门训练演讲的组织，所以有主持人，有评估人，还有一个人。这个人是干嘛的呢？一个很奇怪的单词出现了。这个单词是
is being an MC for a meeting. That is a master of ceremonies. Other assignments include serving as an evaluator for another speaker, or serving as grammarian.Who will monitor use of filler words or phrases such as and, or you know. Both of these assignments will allow the member to increase or enhance their listening skills.
在原文当中大家已经可以看到了这个单词的形式叫 grammarian. 什么叫 grammarian? 这个单词甚至在字典当中是查不到的。它就是这个组织当中的一个角色。当年这个点当中考的这个角色什么意思呀？就是一个人要练演讲的时候，组员们会担任不同的角色，有我们的组长 MC 主持人，还有我们的评估人 evaluator， 还有一个 grammarian。后面的文章里面已经描述了，这个人做一件事情 monitor use of filler words， 他专门来监控你对于口头禅的使用，比如说well， 所以他不是语法老师这样一个角色。整体上来说，这样的一个组织就做一件事情 ,public speaker, MC, evaluator, 这个点没有被读到。你会发现你听到的是 grammarian, 然后他通过这个点来进行干扰。大家看一下 ,public speaker 这个点是什么时间出现的。刚才我们在想这位在开这位假粉的玩笑，这个趋势我们回顾一下。A 选项小心。对，非常好。小姐姐给出了一个翻译叫语法官，很好的一个翻译啊。准备。
Two. The following are job
parliamentary procedures or being master of ceremonies?
Yes. Different assignments within Toastmasters involve not only preparation of speeches.
好的，首先第一件事 not only 不仅仅是对于我们演讲的主持。
Being master of ceremonies?
准备。
Yes.Different assignments within Toastmasters involve not only preparation of speeches.
第二件事情是
and then presenting these before an audience.
好的，同学明白了吗 ？A 选项瞬间就被读过去了，实际上是在不经意之间。他说，不仅包括对于演讲的准备，并且把它呈现在公众面前，而且还包括你要成为一个主持人的这样的一个机会。所以第四题 A 选项是这样说过去的。 核心问题是整个这篇文章都在讲你如何成为一个 public speaker， 所以说这个选项当时语境之下很容易判断。继续，加油。准备好了吗？2008、2006两道题目连续播放，请不要再出现刚才的情况。一道题播放完毕，竟然两道题的答案都可以做出来，不要这样，做好准备。
But also the
Toastmasters
reports do bring
开始。
But airports do bring some local advantages. They bring roads. There's obviously extra employment. For instance, new hotels, shops, restaurants will have to be built. This means more jobs for the locals, and it is good for local economy.
3. Freddie has cited the following advantages for a new airport, except...
I see from your resume that you graduated about 4 years ago, and after that, let me see.
I got a job with the Department of Employment. It was only a temporary thing for about 5 months. I was a researcher in the department. We design a survey, go out to the factories, and ask all the questions of the workers and the management. Then go back to the office, analyze all the data, and produce a report.It was quite interesting, and I guess the psychology course at college helped me a lot.
2. Which of the following is not part of her job with the Department of Employment?
Number 14 was chance.
Who will monitor you and,
But airports do bring some local advantages. They bring roads. There is obviously extra employment.For instance, new hotels, shops, restaurants will have to be built. This means more jobs for the locals, and it is good for local economy.
3. Helped me a lot. Ask all the questions. A researcher in the department.
I see from your resume that you graduated about 4 years ago, and after that, let me see.
I got a job with the Department of Employment. It was only a temporary thing for about 5 months. I was a researcher in the department. We design a survey, go out to the factories,And ask all the questions of the workers and the management. Then go back to the office, analyze all the data, and produce a report.
啊，现在 OK 了吗？各位同学给我反馈。抱歉。Sorry. 讲了半天忘记了开话筒，耽误各位同学时间了。编号为2008年的题目，我重新播放一下这个环节。抱歉。
More jobs for the locals.
再来一遍，准备。
But airports do bring some local advantages. They bring roads. There is obviously extra employment.
首先听到是 roads 指的是道路，然后呢替换的是 A 选项的 more extra employment， 替换的是 more job opportunities。第三题的 A 和 C 过，继续。
For instance, new hotels, shops, restaurants will have to be built. This means more jobs for the locals, and it is good for local economy.
Good for local economy. B 选项替换形式 vitality 活力，对于当地经济非常好。很明显 ，D 选项空乘的人员出现在这一点上是没有被读到的。D 选项是很明显没有被读到的。第二题的形式，加油，准备。
To the office and a job with the department.
I see from your resume that you graduated about 4 years ago, and after that, let me see.
I got a job with the Department of Employment. It was only a temporary thing for about 5 months. I was a researcher in the department. We design a survey.
请看 design survey 替换形式 design questionnaire. 请小心第二题的同义替换，继续。
Go out to the factories.
Go out to the factory. Factory 替换形式 workplace， 也就是在工厂去做这样一些事。
And ask all the questions of the workers and the management. Then go back to the office, analyze all the data.
Analyze data， 进行数据分析。D 选项很明显，这是他在大学时代做的一件事情，上心理学课程。他说心理学课程对他帮助很大，但是跟上心理学的课没有关系。
And produce a report.It was quite interesting, and I guess the psychology course at college helped me a lot.
结束了，这道题目结束。这是2008和2006的题目，实际上也是一个进行这样的一个筛选式的题目。继续往下，笔记本打开，我们做好准备，看一下新点的出现。2013到2014的点，做好准备，加油。尝试一下2013和2014的题目。大家看一下，依然是短选项序列，多个选项被读到时应该怎么办？加油！
Advancement.
Two. Which of the following is not part of her job with the Department of Employment?
Number 14 was chances for promotion.53% said that this was very important to them. It was important to them to have opportunities for advancement, chances for promotion. And I think this goes along with high income and recognition. There's both a psychological reward to promotion as well as a monetary reward. 15 is contact with a lot of people. Some people are very people orientated.And 52% said that this was very important to them.
So we can see workers do have a lot of things that are very important to them.
Yes, but you can also see the variation in numbers.
Five. According to the interviewee, which of the following can offer both psychological and monetary benefits?
What would be the message that you would want to carry out of here back home, or even the message that you would want to get out internationally in terms of what's happening here? The refugee crisis, the consequences that could happen in the future if it's not properly addressed.
I always hate speculation on the news, so I don't want to be somebody who speculates. But I think it's clear that a displaced, unstable population is what happens in Iraq.And how Iraq settles in the years to come is going to affect the entire Middle East. And a big part of what is going to affect how it settles is how these people are returned and settled into their homes, into their community, and brought back together, and whether they can live together, and what their communities look like. So it does have broad implications.
On a personal level, why is this so important to you? You willing to come here and risk your life?
It was a very easy choice to make.
Four. According to Angelina, what is the key issue in solving the refugee problem?
各位辛苦，两题结束，给出反馈的意见。目前一切正常，没问题。给反馈吧，大家的答案分别是什么？果然出现了问题，果然是专业八级的真题，对于各位来说还是有一定的难度的。2013年和2014年的题目，今后请关注一下，注意做。来，准备好。首先，我们从第一题的形式开始，也就是2013的题目。
Important to them.
Job with the department.
开始，加油。
Number 14 was chances for promotion.
各位同学 ，chances for promotion 来自于第五题的 B 选项，已经被读到，请小心做一些准备。第五题应该怎么做标记呢？提醒大家。如果发现多个选项被读到时，那么如果你认为这个选项旁边有一些点是需要做记录的，大家一定记住，在选项旁边做选项记录这样一件事情，永远都是能记多少记多少，尽量记和它相关性你能听到的那个信息。因为我说相关性最强实际上是没有任何标准可言的，你能听到什么就记什么，比如说数据，或者是名词的形式，或者是形容词的形式。但是速记时一定记住那个单词的形式跟我们一般的速记是一样的，前方一两个字母就可以了。准备。
53% said that this was very important to them.
我如果是你 ,B 选项旁边会记一个 53%, 同意吗？给反馈，再来一遍。
It was quite interesting, and I guess the psychology...
14 was chances for promotion.
再来一遍。
53% said that this was very important to them.
小心。
It was important to them to have opportunities for advancement.
好的，很明显 ,B 选项的笔墨是非常重的。这地方 advancement 换成了我们的 promotion, chances, 其实换成了我们的 possibility, 包括我们的这个 opportunities, 继续。
Chances for promotion. And I think this goes along with high income and recognition.There's both a psychological reward to promotion, as well as a monetary reward.
好的，我如果是你的话 ，B 选项旁边甚至会记一个 psychological psy， 或者再记一个 monetary mon money monetary。总之 ，B 选项的这个笔墨是很重的，你也可以把它选中。老规矩，我说过，一个选项选中完毕之后，最好能够等两到三句。继续。
15 is contact with a lot of people.
很明显 ,A 选项被读到了。A 选项旁边可以记一个 15%。你刚刚听到的是 15, 能跟上，继续。
Some people are very people-orientated, and 52% said that this was very important to them.
好的，很明显 ,15 当时是一个序号，你可以记 15%。你也可以再记一个百分之后方听到的这个数据都没有问题。总之你等答案就行，你等问题的形式就好了。这个数据是多少
?Both a psychological reward to promotion,as well as a monetary reward. 15 is contact with a lot of people.
15, 继续。
Some people are very people-orientated, and 52% said that this was very important to them.
这个数据听得不是特别清楚，好像像52又像32，到底是32还是52？我们在这里感觉你能记住都算你对，因为我们在等待问题。52和32都选择 A 选项就可以了，没问题，继续。
So we can see workers do have a lot of things that are very important to them.
Yes, but you can also see the variation in numbers.
没了。等待答案的形式。
5. According to the interviewee, which of the following can offer both psychological and monetary benefits?
听到的既是 psychological and monetary， 最终准确答案形式来自于 B 选项。这道题目实际上很明显是 A 和 B 之间选，但是如果从做题的技巧上来考量，2013年这道题依然是重点选 B 的。为什么？因为 B 选项在原文当中花的笔墨和时间要比 A 选项多多了，它其实多次出现了重复。好，过下一道题目，准备下一道题，关于一个访谈伊拉克，开始。
In terms of what's happening here, what would be the message that you would want to carry out of here back home, or even the message that you would want to get out internationally in terms of what's happening here? The refugee crisis, the consequences that could happen in the future if it's not properly addressed.
好，完全听不太懂，但我们知道，在这道题目当中，伊拉克这个点已经开始出现， 所以眼神开始聚集到这个位置上。
I always hate speculation on the news, so I don't want to be somebody who speculates. But I think it's clear that a displaced unstable population is what happens in Iraq, and how Iraq settles in the years to come is going to affect the entire Middle East. And a big part of what is going to affect how it settles is how these people are returned and settled into their homes, into their community, and brought back together, and whether they can live together, and what their communities look like. So it does have broad implications.
结束了。这道题目对于各位来说实际上是一道比较标准的专业八级的一道长对话的题目。其实我们会发现对于第四题我们几乎没有听懂太多的东西。但是按照视听一致的理论基本上这样一些点被读到了。他们分别是 international, 以及 Iraq, 以及我们的 return, 以及 living 这样的点。最终通过谁被读到更多这样的一个点选择的是 B 选项。我们来看一下它的理解点在哪里。我还是希望各位同学能够看到在这道题目当中它实际上是通过了一些关于重点信息的汇总。大家看一下这个位置 big part of what is going to affect how it settles is 解决这样一件问题的核心最大的部分在于这些人如何回到家园并且回到自己的家并且回到自己的社区并且回到正常的生活状态当中去。That's it. 抱歉这是我一个标记的问题准确答案形式来自于这个 Refugee return to normal life. 关注这一个位置就可以了。来做好准备我们再看一道题加油。2012年两道题目即将出现准备。
On a personal level, why is this so important to you? You willing to come here and risk your life?
It was a very easy...
Creates. People often wonder how the human brain creates. For example...A beautiful painting, a sculpture, or even a delicious dinner. Today, we are honored to have Dr. Nancy Andreasen, a neuroscientist at the University of Iowa, on our talk show. Dr. Andreasen has recently written a book called The Creating Brain, The Neuroscience of Genius. In her book, she tackles the question and tries to look into the brain behind creativity. Dr. Andreasen,Thanks for coming on our show.
Pleasure.
Now, Dr. Andreasen, can we start with a question? What is creativity?
Well, creativity can be seen as a process. This process starts with a person, for example, an artist, musician, inventor, or even someone who's trying to figure out a better way of doing a task at work or at home. That person must think about the problem or their project in a novel way and then come up with a solution.
I see. But how long will it take for the person to find the solution, as it were?
Well, it depends. The creative process can go by in a flash or it can take years. But the end result is, invariably, the production of something new and useful, such as the automobile, or something beautiful and artistic, such as a painting by Vincent van Gogh.
Do you think there is a creative personality?
Well, perhaps we can put it this way. Gifted people in the arts or science tend to enjoy adventure. They often like to explore new places or ideas. They don't like being hemmed in by rules or convention, and they often look at problems from a different angle. Another point is they often have to move doggedly ahead on a project, even when the outside world rejects their art or new ideas.
Which of the following statements about creativity is incorrect? 4. Which of the following features of a creative personality is not mentioned in the interview?
Ask
at work or at home.
Coming on our show.
Pleasure.
Now, Dr. Andreasen, can we start with a question? What is creativity?
2012年的第一题，这道题目还是有一些难度的，也算是一道比较专业八级中上难度的一个水平。同一题换速度非常的快，加油，开始。
Well, creativity can be seen as a process.This process starts with a person, for example, an artist, musician, inventor, or even someone who's trying to figure out a better way of doing a task at work or at home. That person must think about the problem or their project in a novel way and then come up with a solution.
I see. But how long will it take for the person to find the solution, as it were?
Well, it depends. The creative process can go by in a flash, or it can take years. But the end result is, invariably, the production of something new and useful, such as the automobile, or something beautiful and artistic, such as a painting by Vincent van Gogh.
来自于 C 选项的这个点，这种比较是没有出现过的。因为原文当中说了，创新这样一件事，或者是创造这样一件事情，不但是需要想，同时还需要做。大家做得非常好，不但需要想，同时还需要做。大家看一下 A 选项，很简单，创意来自于创新思维，成功。B 选项，时间完全因人而异。我们听到了这个过程当中有几天的，有几周的，有几年的成功。接下来 D 选项，来自于创意的结果因人而异，或者是每个人形式都不一样。我们听到了梵高，有的人可能是一幅画，有的人可能是其他的作品。 D 选项成功。很明显，来自于整个2012这道题目就是一个否定方向的一个选择，整个三个选项都成功，只有一个选项不对。大家可以想象一下，这种题在过去是非常有难度的，但是在2016之后没有出现过这样的题目。我们更喜欢问的是以下哪一项是对的。这道题目很有趣，我们来认识一下，不但考察了单词的用法，同时还让各位同学明白哪一个选项和语文当中的符合点是最多的。
There is a creative personality?
Well, perhaps we can put it this way. Gifted people in the arts or science tend to enjoy adventure. They often like to explore new places or ideas. They don't like being hemmed in by rules or convention, and they often look at problems from a different angle.Another point is they often have to move doggedly ahead on a project, even when the outside world rejects their art or new ideas.
结束了。在这个过程当中，我们来看一下原文当时说的是什么。首先第一件事情是他们不喜欢被陷入在传统当中，有这个短语的形式性小性 don't like being hemmed in rules by rules or convention。 准确答案形式已经成功了，大家看一下，来自于我们的第一个选项 unconventional， 替换速度非常快。有空的话这道题的同一替换的形式稍后做题的时候总结一下，他们是不传统的。接下来后方又出现了一句话，这句话当时是这样说的，看清楚 from a different point of view or from different angle， 从不同角度来说。说到不同角度的话，会有两个选项给大家给干扰，第一个单词的形式 original， 第二个单词的形式 critical。 最终我们来认识一下这两个选项对于大家来说啊， 怎么说呢？我觉得这道题实际上对于各位来说最重要的应该是你听懂原文和选项的一个这样的一个替换关系。我个人认为这句话对于各位的影响，它其实是可以直接去影响两个选项的，大家是否同意？从不同角度去说，从不同的角度去说，大家想一想看，我个人认为这道题这两个选项都被包含了，大家给我一个反馈，是否同意？就是看问题的时候，我们角度是不一样的，要么是叫做原创的，要么是叫做批判性思维的。就是独特的嘛。然后呢，还有一个选项在这里，这个选项是说 another point is， 很明显，换一个题目，他们在对待事情的时候非常非常的 doggedly， 义无反顾向前走，替换形式 resolute。 所以如果说你能理解这道题目，对于过去有一些出题的信度和效度不高的选项，我们就不用纠结了。核心问题是还是在上一节课讲过的一件事情，大家务必要像我一样，在做完历史上所有真题之后，搞清楚选项在原文当中的对应关系。这种同义替换或者是选项在原文当中的这样一种总结，对于大家在一月份和二月份积蓄实力非常非常有帮助。大家懂我的意思吗？所以对于这道题来说，以下哪一项没有选到，我们意义觉得就不大了。每一个点其实都可以在原文当中被找到，你知道就可以了。所以不要纠结准确答案，只要你能理解原文就可以。这件事情应该在范范老师的阅读课上其实出现过更多的频率，不同老师对于阅读的这种答案都有不一样的理解，这些都没有关系，核心问题是那篇文章你本身读懂就可以了。嗯，好啊，这道题啊，做一下吧，很简单，准备好，即将开始单题的形式，在今天的尾部我们会有连续题目的拷问，准备。
Which of the following statements about creativity is incorrect? 4. Which of the following features of a creative personality is not mentioned in the interview?
5. Could you tell us a bit about the background of the organization?
I am delighted to have that opportunity.Toastmasters is an international organization designed to develop effective speaking and listening skills.
And what kind of members do you have now?
Well, many people think Toastmasters is open only to those individuals who wish to be professional speakers. But that is definitely not true. Toastmasters is open to the public at large.Any individual who wishes to improve his public speaking is welcome. And also, those who just want to increase their overall self-confidence are encouraged to attend.
Please, 各位同学做一下选择，准确答案形式。大家没有发现这道题目在整个选项设计上已经有漏洞了，大家选的非常的好，很明显这道题很明显问的应该是一下哪一项是不对的，一看就看出来了，一下哪一项是对的，大家看一下有没有发现选项之间实际上是有冲突的，大家能看出来吗？哪两项其实是很明显是冲突的，大家看出来吗？比如说来自于这个 B 选项，对吧，来自于 C 选项，来自于 D 选项，这几个选项有点冲突啊，看出来了哈。我们再听一下这个位置，准备。
Speaking and listening
is not mentioned.
开始。
Toastmasters is an international organization designed to develop effective speaking and listening skills.
A 选项少了一个 listening， 过。继续往下 ，A 选项错，继续往下，跟上。
And what kind of members do you have now?
Well, many people think Toastmasters is open only to those individuals who wish to be professional speakers.
很多人认为我们的这样的一个俱乐部只是去关注或者是只是开放给一些专业的演讲人的，来自于地选项已经被表达清楚，这是他进行转折。
But that is definitely not true.
也就是说这一项完全不对， definitely not true. 继续。
Toastmasters is open to the public at large. Any individual who wishes to improve his public speaking is welcome. And also, those who just want to increase their overall self-confidence are encouraged to attend.
很明显，来自于 B 选项和 C 选项，我们听到的是 open at large, open to public at large, 广泛意义上开放给公众，准确答案是 C 选项。大家仔细看这道题目，这是2009年的原题形式，其实甚至我再说一种可能性，这种可能性就是实在有一些选项最终选不出来的时候，甚至是可以通过逻辑的形式进行一些判定。很明显，当时的 B 选项和 D 选项实际上讲的是一件事。历史的真题在出题的时候，我们再说一遍，真的并不是所有的题目都非常非常的精确与精良。大家能看出来吗？ B 和 D 其实是一件事情。好，继续往下，加油。做完这一切之后，来往下走。请各位同学打开笔记，关于解题方法当中标记的问题，我刚刚说过，如果发现更多选项被读到，或者是已经听到准确答案时，如果发现这个准确答案本身选项比较短，建议大家进行简单的临近信息记忆。这些速记当中需要去速记的点最好有包括比如说数据，比如说和最高级相关的一些表达，比如说各种各样的强调，包括标志性的名词和形容词的一些信息等等。请关注，刚才我们做过关于一些和数据相关的选项标记的问题。啊，有同学说速度非常快，来不及写。我再说一遍啊，能记多少记多少，千万记住不要给自己太大压力。能记多少记多少，就听，就记那些你听到的。对，就记那些你听到的即可。另外，在整个这样的一个长对话的原文当中，我们还是再度请各位同学关注一下。在迷你当中所谓的答案区域，在我们的长对话当中几乎全部出现了。很明显，这样一些信号词后的信息将会更容易成为我们的被强调点的信息。大家看一下在公屏上出现的这样一些内容，包括叙述词的形式、逻辑词汇、重复说明、比较级、最高级、例句和限定词汇等等，其实全部都是来自于迷你演讲过程当中的一些对于迷你演讲答案的引导的一些设置和方法。据说这个场子已经倒闭了，我们做题吧。对，大家老你看专八的听力可以练六级是不是？那个这样吧，那个今天那个我们偷会儿糖吧，大家都别跑行不行？我想让各位同学多练几道长对话。好，加油，做好准备。29页的题目，准备好吗？29页的第一题到第五题，准备好了吗？我相信你一看题目就知道，编号为第二题可能不是善茬，是吧？ 编号为第二题不是善茬。提醒大家，这篇长对话是我们2007年的一道长对话，时间大约是7分钟，请各位同学坚持住。长对话算是比较长的一个序列，连续5道题，问题会在后方连续问出，做好准备。提醒大家，编号为第5题选项较长，选项比较长的题目建议大家提前看一下，这样的话后方压力会少一些。
Section B. Interview. Nigel Lint is editor of Business Travel Weekly. Nigel, thanks for being on the show. Now, what kind of problems do airline passengers face nowadays?
Well, most of the problems are caused by the heavy volume of traffic.You know, all airports have a limit on the number of takeoffs and landings they can handle.
So, what seems to be the problem?
All flights from a busy airport arrive and leave at more or less the same time. If 60 aircraft are scheduled to take off between 5 p.m. and 5:15, the airport can only handle 120 an hour.That means some will always be late landing or taking off. And if the weather is bad, you can imagine what the situation is like. So, passengers have to be loaded into each plane, and then the planes have to line up to take off.
So, waiting at the lounge or on the plane is quite common.
Certainly. And another problem that is very common is...Overbooking. Quite often, you hear an announcement on the airport lounge speakers, We have oversold on this flight and would like volunteers to go on the next flight out. If you decide to volunteer, you may get a cash bribe or a free trip voucher, but make sure you get a guaranteed seat on the next flight and a free phone call to whoever is meeting you on the other end. And worst,You'll still arrive with a confirmed reservation and discover you have been bumped off the flight.
Presumably, if you choose to travel at off-peak times, there are fewer problems.
Well, there are no off-peak times. All flights seem to be full except Saturday. I don't quite understand why this is so. You know, if there is a public holiday, things are likely to be especially busy.The special fare systems on the airline's computers encourage more people to fly on less popular flights, and this means that all flights are equally full.
So, what advice would you give to business travelers?
I'd say avoid big airports if you can. The reason is that there are too many flights there. Then, remember not to check your baggage if you can help it.Another thing is, be prepared for delays. Take something to eat and drink in your hand luggage.
Nigel, what kind of mistakes do inexperienced travelers make?
The first mistake business travelers make is to take far too much luggage. Remember, take only carry-on luggage because at most airports, you can get away with 2 small bags.
Oh, I see.
Another mistake people make is to think you have to pay full price for air tickets. You should find out about the different ticket options. For example, an RTW fare can save up to 40% on the normal fare.
Excuse me, what is RTW?
Round the world. For example, if you're going to Australia from the USA, you could go out via Singapore and come back via North America. And another way to save money is to see if a ticket to a destination beyond is cheaper. For example, a ticket through Amsterdam from London to New York may be cheaper than one straight from London to New York.
That's very good information.
And another mistake is to go away for too long. Most people's efficiency and energy start to fall off after 2 weeks away. So, my advice is to keep your trip short. Only go for 2 weeks and never for longer than three. Another point is, don't expect everything to go to plan. You need to learn to expect the unexpected. There may be a typhoon in summer, or your taxi might break down on your way to the airport. In other words, don't be optimistic about plans, and don't schedule important meetings too closely together. You need to allow time for delays and breakdowns.
Yeah, this is something travelers have to remember when they plan their trips.
And another thing, get to know a good travel agent and make sure he gives you the best possible service. Take discounts, for example. A good travel agent can get first-class tickets for the price of business class. This is because he does enough volume of business that he can get discount with airlines on his own behalf. He should pass them on to you, so make sure he indeed does.
I think the worst part of the trip is to travel overnight or being stuck for a weekend in a dreadful place. Are there any ways of avoiding that?
Yes, a weekend break or a stopover in a relaxing, more lively place is often available at a special cheap weekend rate. Various airlines and hotel chains offer these, and it's always more pleasant to stay in a hotel than in a plane, even if you travel business class.
Yes. Okay, thank you, Nigel, for all the information and useful travel advice.
2007. 1. According to Nigel, what is the cause of most problems of air travel? Two. Which of the following is not mentioned as compensation for volunteers for the next flight? Three. Why does Nigel suggest that business travelers avoid big airports? Four. According to Nigel, inexperienced travelers are likely to make the following mistakes except 5. Which of the following statements is incorrect?
结束了，我们看一下准确答案的形式，大家做的怎么样？哎呀，七号风衣同学做的非常好，全对了，恭喜啊 ！Sophie 同学，你要小心啊！我在六级听力班级当中等你。恭喜恭喜大家 ，B A B A C。现在在第三题上出现问题应该比较大，以及在第二题上出现问题比较大，给反馈是这样的。我们今天重点解决一下第二题和第三题的形式。啊，最后一道题，哎，有同学把最后一道题做错了，太遗憾了。Attention 同学，大家没有感觉到最后一道题已经露出了破绽吗？同学们，来，全班关注一下最后第五题， 第五题本身有破绽呢，那就是我们的 C 选项。大家看，在2007年的时候，出题人他漏了一个破绽， C 选项本身出现了一个绝对肯定的表达，叫做 every detail。 C 选项说的是计划履行每一个细节，提前进行计划是非常非常必要的。提前进行计划没问题，但是每一个细节你不觉得非常的可疑吗？这就是第五题的一个形式。第四题这道题在原文当中也算是比较清楚的一个表达。今天第二题和第三题老师值得说一下，准备开始。
Have a limit on the number of takeoffs and landings they can handle.
So, what seems to be the problem?
All flights from a busy airport arrive and leave at more or less the same time. If 60 aircraft are scheduled to take off between 5 p.m. and 5:15, the airport can only handle 120 an hour. That means some will always be late landing or taking off.
第一题实际上不停地在说一件事情，就是机场的荷载能量是有限的。今天第一题和第三题其实讲的是一件事，大家稍后重新听第二遍的时候就非常的清楚。第一题和第三题讲的是一件事，就是机场能力有限。继续等。
And if the weather is bad,
小雪同学，这道题的时间是2007年。
You can imagine what the situation is like. So, passengers have to be loaded into each plane, and then the planes have to line up to take off.
So, waiting at the lounge or on the plane is quite common.
Certainly. And another problem that is very common is overbooking.
Another problem, 这个单词一出现，第二题就开始切换了。Overbooking, 第一题的 overbooking 讲完之后，第二题很快接上。
Quite often, you hear an announcement on the airport lounge speakers, We have oversold on this flight and would like volunteers to go on the next flight out.If you decide to volunteer, you may get a cash bribe or a free trip voucher.
好的，各位同学 ,cash bribe or a free trip voucher. 大家看一下 ,cash bribe, 什么叫 bribe? Bribe, 直接理解为叫做行贿，说白了实际上就是 cash. 如果说我们超售了，那么我们就会听到这样的一个通知，有没有任何的志愿者可以去坐下一班的飞机。于是我们就会给他一些补偿，比如说你会得到的是 cash bribe, 现金补偿，来自于 C 选项 and a free trip voucher. 大家看一下 voucher 这单词的中文含义是啥，它叫代金券，但是 A 选项写的是 free ticket, 叫做免费的机票，这两个 ticket 和 voucher 的统一替换，不行的问题，继续往下。
But make sure you get a guaranteed seat on the next flight.
Guaranteed seat flight, 也就是说保证你要确定你在下一个航班当中是有这样的一个这个座位的。
And a free phone call to whoever is meeting you on the other end.
Free phone call, B 选项成功了。
And worst, you'll still arrive with a confirmed reservation and discover you have been bumped off the flight.
好的，最差的事情是在下一个航班上你依然确定的是你能够有一个确定的这样的一个座位的预定，然后依然被踢出来了。第二题这道题说的就是如果航班超售你能获得的补偿有哪一些，它们分别是 free phone call, 免费的电话，长途的 B 选项 seat reservation, 叫做座位的预定，以及我们的 cash bribe, 也就是现金的补偿。没有提到的是谁，问的是一个否定选项，答案 free ticket。 结束了，现在第三题，小心啊。
Presumably, if you choose to travel at off-peak times, there are fewer problems.
Well, there are no off-peak times. All flights seem to be full except Saturday.
根本就没有高峰期，因为所有的航班好像都是满的。听到了这句话 ,all the flights are full, 第三题的 A 选项被你选中了。稍微等一会儿。
I don't quite understand why this is so.You know, if there is a public holiday, things are likely to be especially busy. The special fare systems on the airline's computers encourage more people to fly on less popular flights, and this means that all flights are equally full.
所有的航班都是满员的。第三题 A 选项选中了，稍微等一等。
So, what advice would you give to business travelers?
这时出现了一个选项，请小心 ,business traveler, 商务旅行者，你有什么建议？
I'd say avoid big airports if you can. The reason is that there are too many flights there. Then remember not to check your baggage if you can help it.
结束了。第三题在最后问你的时候，问的就是 business traveler。你一定要给这些商务旅行者给一些建议的话，你会有什么样的建议？这时你听到的声音是
To business travelers.
I'd say avoid big airports if you can. The reason is that there are too many flights there.
这时你会发现 C 选项很明显进行这个 B 选项很明显进行了同义替换，也就是说航班太满了。Too many flights there. B 选项 because 这个点替换的是 reason， 然后 too many flights 替换的是 volume of traffic is so heavy。另外第三题既然 A 和 B 都是对的， B 选项旁边最好能够记录一下 business 这个点。最终第三题通过问题确定准确答案形式选的是。这道题结束了。哎呀，大家还都在现场，那个场控也在等我。我这样吧，再让各位同学做一道题。我说既然要拖我就拖一会儿吧，因为我给大家布置了作业嘛。我再说一遍，我曾经给大家说过一月份到二月份的时间多做六级的题目。以及大家记住，如果你觉得我讲听力带着你做听力或者是练听力的一种能力能够让你的血槽加满的话，这个课程叫做六级听力吃透课程。六级听力吃透课程目前还在优惠期，对，我停留大概五秒钟的时间，大家如果感兴趣拍张照片一会儿看一看里边的课程介绍。太贵了，嗯，别这样，我不知道为什么别这样。对，提醒大家，这里面包括有什么啊？就是每天练十五个句子左右，就是让各位同学听懂。然后每两天会有一个复习，然后就是还有这个听力打卡的一个活动等等。好的，希望有道考试能够成为各位同学的工资收割机。接下来的时间我们安排一道六级的题目，大家看一下六级长对话对你的影响，感受一下，我觉得挺好的，辛苦大家了啊，来动手，请大家翻书本，给大家准备好了，全班同学动手，页码位置39页，谢谢。啊，对，我这个页码跟大家不太一样，编号为39页，准备好吗？大家看一看六级的题目，给反馈准备好了吗？然后大家看一下有没有感觉特别的像。然后六级的题目当中，大家一看选项就会发现23题和24题是那种大家可能得多个心眼的题目，感觉到了吗？23题和24题是需要多个心眼的题目，交给大家，准备开始。
What happened?
Conversation two.Did you hear about the air crash that occurred in South America recently? It was quite a tragic accident.
No, I didn't see anything in the news about it. What happened?
A foreign airliner was attempting to land at night in a mountainous area of Argentina and flew into a hill.
That sounds really terrible. Did anyone survive?
No, everyone aboard, including the crew, was killed instantly.
What were the circumstances? Was there bad weather, a fire, or an engine failure?
Apparently, there were some low clouds in the area, but mostly it was just miscommunication between the pilots and the air traffic controllers.
Weren't they both speaking in English? the official international aviation language?
Yes, they were, but the transmission from poor quality radios was slightly distorted, and the accents of the Spanish-speaking controllers were so strong that the pilots misunderstood a vital instruction.
How could a misunderstanding like that cause such a serious accident?
The pilots were told, descend to 22,000 feet. The instruction actually meant 22,000 feet, but they thought they heard descend to 2,000 feet. That's a huge difference and should have been confirmed, but it was not. Unfortunately, the terrain of the mountains in that region extends up to 20,000 feet.
So the pilots did descend to the wrong altitude then, thinking they were following the air controller's instruction.
Sadly enough, yes, they did. It was a very bad mistake. Many people died as a result of this simple misunderstanding.
Wow, that's a powerful lesson in how important it can be to accurately communicate with each other. Questions 23 to 25 are based on the conversation you have just heard. Question 23. What was the cause of the tragedy? Question 24. How high are the mountains in the region? Question 25. What lesson could be drawn from the accident?
Sophie 同学，要小心了。确认一下准确答案的形式。哎呀呀，一到六级的程度以后把大家搞成这个样子，赶紧在寒假去听六级的听力的内容，这个基本功赶紧得唤醒了，你们这个做听力时间太少了。当然这道题本身大家看，答应我，无论是否上午的六级听力吃透课程，一月份到二月份好好练习六级的长对话加专业八级的听力真题，给我反馈，你们会这样做吗？因为你们之前练听力的时间太少，赶紧利用这个时间把它补回来。我就在想一件事啊，那些到现在为止还不准备转八的同学，他们的心真够大的，真的，你们做了题就知道你们老不练最后的结果是什么。
This area of quite a tragic accident. Conversation 2.
加油。
Did you hear about the air crash that occurred in South America recently? It was quite a tragic accident.
No, I didn't see anything in the news about it. What happened?
A foreign airliner was attempting to land at night in a mountainous area of Argentina and flew into a hill.
好的，大概就听懂了一句话，飞机撞到山里去了， flew into a hill.
That sounds really terrible. Did anyone survive?
有人活了吗？
No, everyone aboard, including the crew, was killed instantly.
Killed instantly. 各位同学看一下，原文当中都有被秒杀了，继续。
What were the circumstances? Was there bad weather, a fire, or an engine failure?
Apparently,
速度太快了，大家看一下。Was it because of bad weather? 天气很差吗？这位女士真的是深藏不露， A 选项瞬间过，然后 engine failure。大家看，速度好快，统一替换 breakdown 替换的是 failure， engine 被读到 ，A 选项、C 选项瞬间过，很明显并列选项呀。继续。
There were some low clouds in the area, but mostly it was just miscommunication.
但是果然是应试型题目，规矩很好，规矩感非常的好。大家听这个点，再来一遍。
But mostly, there were some low clouds in the area. But mostly clouds in the area. But mostly, it was just miscommunication. But mostly,
大家有感觉吗？叫做 but mostly, but mostly, 但是主要的来说是因为
it was just miscommunication between the pilots and the air traffic controllers.
Miscommunication between pilots and air traffic controllers. 是因为我们的飞行员和空中交通管制之间的一个 miscommunication。 大家看一下 D 选项说的是啥， D 选项说的是交流系统或者是通讯系统的故障，通讯系统没故障。稍后你听的时候你会发现是两个人之间交流的问题导致的。这道题实际上是一道心机题目，这道题完全可以接近专业八级的水平。这道题准确答案是 B 选项。继续往下，搞笑的20和12，为什么？
Weren't they both speaking in English, the official international aviation language?
Yes, they were, but the transmission from poor quality radios was slightly distorted.
好的，首先信号叫做 the quality from the radio. The transmission from the radio was distorted.被扭曲了。
And the accents of the Spanish-speaking controllers were so strong that the pilots misunderstood a vital instruction.
How could a misunderstanding like that cause such a serious accident?
The pilots were told, descend to 22,000 feet. The instruction actually meant 22,000 feet, but they thought they heard, descend to 2,000 feet.
大家听懂了吗？首先我们的这个空中交通管制员是有口音的，西班牙口音。接下来他说了一句话叫 descend to 2,000 feet， 什么意思？请下降到22,000英尺。听清楚，下降到22,000英尺。这是
That's a huge difference.
他们听成了下降到2,000英尺。也就是说这个过程当中的 descend to 2,000 feet， 也就是22,000 feet， 然后这个过程当中的各种 to 连在一起，直接听成了下降到2,000英尺。
And should have been confirmed.
这件事情需要被确定。
But it was not.
但是并没有。
Unfortunately, the terrain of the mountains in that region extends up to 20,000 feet.
大家有没有发现，这道题也是安排了一个机会，这个单词出现了。
Mountains in that region is different and should have been confirmed, but it was not. Unfortunately, confirmed.But it was not. Unfortunately,
有同学说读到最后的才是对的，我不确定啊。我们最好不要做这样的判断。这个道题目之所以被选中，实际上是因为一个单词的形式。这个单词应该是 unfortunately。这个点我觉得很重要。继续。
The terrain of the mountains in that region extends up to 20,000 feet.
So the pilots did descend to the wrong altitude then.
所以我如果是你的话，旁边写了一个 mountain。 这道题目被点到的形式分别是下降高度22,000，实际下降高度2,000，以及山的高度20,000，最终下得太降得太低了，导致直接撞山了，这就是这道题目的形式。最后一道题非常的清楚，做好准备跟上。
Thinking they were following the air controller's instruction.
Sadly enough, yes they did. It was a very bad mistake.Many people died as a result of this simple misunderstanding.
Wow, that's a powerful lesson in how important it can be to accurately communicate with each other.
25题的 accurate communication 和 important 全部成功，这道题结束了，挺好的。欢迎各位同学在寒假我们不见面的时间，通过六级听力直通课程的形式跟我继续见面啊，没有什么问题。另外呢，在这个强化阶段还有部分的题目我没有做完啊，这些题目留给大家当作业吧，挺好的。实际上还有两篇迷你演讲，大家可以去自己听听看，然后还有一个长对话，在那个长对话我们在整个六级听力的长对话当中都已经包含了。那么所有的音频材料在我们的班级 Q 群当中都有，大家听我们的班级 Q 群当中音频材料当中的最后一段就可以找到了。我再度和各位同学见面的时间，我们再确认一下，再度和大家见面的时间就要到这个时间了，竟然是在明年的时间。再和各位见面就是明年的三月份了，冲刺断见。那么整个听力环节我要交代的所有重点基本上已经交代结束了。这张 PPT 请大家好生留着，再说一遍，一月份到二月份好好练听力。再见就是明年，提前祝各位同学猪年快乐，提前祝各位同学在猪年实现自己的所有梦想。感谢大家，我不露脸了，我今天没有洗脸，所以没脸见大家。没关系，在未来还有很多见面的机会，后面还有一些公开课什么的，大家有空的话可以去听听看。 然后顺便在公开课上给那些新同学宣布一下，我们这个课程其实对他们来说还是很有用的。再次感谢各位同学对有道考生的支持，大家辛苦了，记住我们的学习并没有结束，专八加油，外语学的男生和女生不认输，再见。